You're about to listen to the unadulterated word of God from Reverend David Kakati.
In the book of Romans, he said, when we were enemies, Romans chapter 5, verse 10. He said, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son. Much more than be reconciled, we shall be saved by His life. We shall be saved by His life. This is one of the secrets of our salvation. He said, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son. Not by the opinion of anybody. Not by the recommendation of anybody. Not by the standard of anybody. Not by what social media is saying. Not by what World Health Organization is saying. Not by what any politician is saying. He said, when we were enemies, Romans chapter 5, verse 10. When we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son. By the death of His Son. Say in the name of Jesus Christ. Because what you cannot declare, you don't deserve it. What you cannot declare, you don't deserve. And what you cannot say, you cannot see it. Say in the name of Jesus Christ. Say it again. Say in the name of Jesus Christ. Every enmity between me and God, right now, by the death of Jesus Christ, it is removed. It is removed. Say right now, any wall, any obstacle, any barrier standing between me and God, say by the death of His Son, Jesus Christ, it is removed. It is uprooted. It is overthrown. In the mighty name of Jesus, say right now, every utterance, every pronouncement that has come between me and my God, I remove you by the death of Jesus Christ. I remove you by the death of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Sit down. So anything that disqualifies you, that makes you unworthy before God, that makes you unacceptable before God, it can be taken care of. I said it has been taken care of by the death of His Son Jesus Christ. Say, I believe in the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Say, I believe in the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Therefore, I declare no spirit, no altar, no curse, no power, no spirit, no character shall stand between me and the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, say, I am reconciled unto the Lord by the death of Jesus Christ.
Praise
God.
Hallelujah.
People are going to church, but they don't know what connect them with God. They don't
know.
They don't know. They think it is their closeness with a certain man. They think it is the position they have. They think it is the praises that they sing upon them in the church. That is what makes them acceptable before God. You must know what connects you with God. You must know what makes you worthy in the sight of God. You must know what gives you a place before God.
before God and begin to announce it and begin to walk in it. Men can say whatever they say, but you and God, there is no problem, because you have the secret. You know the secret. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And then he said, much more, be reconciled, we shall be saved by his life.
If he's
deaf, can remove enmity between you and God. He's deaf. Can remove his enmity between you and God. Then what will happen when his life begins to work in your life? What will happen? Am I communicating to somebody? He's deaf, cry. He's deaf. He's deaf. He's able to make you and God to become one and connected.
Then,
what will happen when he resurrects from the dead? As for that one, it's too much. So you are not vulnerable. You are secured. You are redeemed. You are delivered. You are untouchable. Let them say whatever they can say. Something higher is speaking. Say, by the death of his son and by the resurrection of his son, let all negative utterances be silenced. Amen.
Amen.
This one will make you serve God with confidence. Because you know what you have. It is not based on the approval of men.
It is based
on the approval of God and what God has said. That was why the early church, they went to prison with pride. They went to prison with pride because they knew what they were carrying. Yes, the soldiers and the government of the time said you are guilty, and they went to prison with pride because they knew what they had. When you know this, you are ready to suffer for him. Because you have the approval of the superior one. You have the approval of the superior one. So take me to court. And judge me. And take me to prison. I have something better. That's how come Apostle Paul, it was in prison that he wrote most of the epistles. It was in prison.
Yes.
They thought when they put him in prison, they have finished him. But they didn't know that in the prison, his destiny and his calling will rather manifest. So in the prison, then he took pen. He started writing the book of Romans, 1 Corinthians,
2 Corinthians,
Philippians, Galatians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, Ephesians. It was in prison. The prison could not stop him. The realm that we are operating from,
you
mean affliction cannot stop. Suffering cannot stop us. Character assassination cannot stop us. Insult cannot stop us. Discouragement cannot stop us. Because we carry something higher. We carry something higher. I pray for somebody that is listening to me, that every attempt to sit on you, every attempt to sit on your destiny, every attempt to sit on your salvation, every attempt to sit on your spirituality, by the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, it is broken. I said, by the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, it is broken. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy over your life. Even in prison, you shall explode higher and higher. Even when they attack you, you shall explode higher and higher. When they disgrace you, you shall go higher and higher. In the mighty name of Jesus, shout, I am unstoppable. Shout, I am unstoppable. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
sit down.
What you're trying to say?
So you can't stop us. You can't stop us. You can't stop us.
Let me see and quine.
People are ready to serve everything except God. They will use the most fruitful part of their life, the greenness and the freshest part of their life to serve earthly governments. To serve earthly governments. Then when they have retired from the earthly government, and the government said, now you are not useful to us. Now you are 60 years. We have no value for you. So go on retirement. When their head have become gray and their strength is gone and they cannot do much for God, then they say they are becoming pastors. As for God, he doesn't deserve good things. He doesn't. We give him leftovers. Is what we give to God. The unwanted, the useless, that is what we give to God. By the time that you are energetic, the time that your brain is sharp, the time that you are alert, the time that you have all the resources, you tell God, go and sit somewhere. Let me invest my life and my resources in the world. Then what is not needed, I give to you. So people will go to heaven one day and they don't have any inheritance there. They will go there, but they don't have anything there because they invested everything here. And as for here, it cannot cross the grave. The value here cannot cross the grave.
So
we have to learn to invest in God. Every time it must be at the back of your head. What am I doing for God? That will give me inheritance in heaven. Your faith in Jesus Christ can give you a place in heaven. Yes. Your faith in Jesus Christ can give you a place in heaven. Yes. But your inheritance in heaven, your influence in heaven, your position in heaven, your superiority in heaven, your influence in heaven is determined by the services you render to God. The investment you have made in God, that will determine your influence there. So the levels are not the same.
Yes.
Even among the angels, they are higher ranks. We have normal angels before we have archangels.
Before
we have cherubims and we have seraphims.
And
we have watchers.
Cherubims and seraphims.
Praise God. Are we sure we are serving God? The other time I told you that to serve means to wait on somebody. That is why when you go to the restaurant, we call them waiters or servers. And the waiters and the servers, they don't sit. They are always standing and walking and moving. So when you come to church, you are not serving God. God is serving you. When you come to church, it is God that is serving you. That's why you are sitting down. You are sitting down. And God is serving you through me, a waiter. God is serving. I am the waiter. I am ministering to you. I am dishing out the food for you. I am dishing out the food for you. The word of God is the food. I am fetching it for you. So some of you are sitting down. Some of you have crossed your legs. Comfortable. So the one who is doing the work is the one who is sitting down. So when you go to church on Sunday, You are not serving God. God is the one who is serving you. You are going to eat. You are going so that they can feed you and minister to you. So many of us are not serving God. Praise God. Yes. And even that crowd, we have metamorphosed to Sunday to Sunday. We have metamorphosed. It is not that you have gone to work. It is not that you are on duty anywhere. But you have locked your head. We have locked our head. And me. God does not deserve anything extra from me.
Yes.
Anything extra I have must go to the world. And even the Sunday to Sunday. Even the Sunday to Sunday crowd, we have divided it into two.
I
said, this Sunday I will go. Next Sunday.
Next week,
to fiakwa. It will never happen. I will never go.
If
the man of God, like, you should call me 20 times. I'll just tell him I will come, but in my heart, I will not go.
So, I will call me
am I communicating to somebody at all? Oh, I said, am I communicating to somebody? So we saw that when you serve God, you attract the blessing of God. Exodus 23:25. Exodus 23:25. When you serve God, you attract the blessing of God.
So
you shall serve the Lord your God, and He will bless your bread and your water. Number two, service to God takes away sicknesses. It enhances health. So he said, you shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your bread and your water, and he will take sickness away from your
midst.
Service to God. Service to God. When we are going to work, we work fast to work. But when we are going to the house of God, we walk anyhow. We have been exposed that we don't really value God. Yes. When you are going to work, you walk fast, hurriedly to work. But when you are going to the house of God, onyangali. Those who understand that, onyangali. Yes. Then you cut walk one after the other. Then when you close from work, you take your time slowly before you leave the workplace. But when you close from church, fast. You want to leave the church. When is there? I saw somebody.
America.
The person came to church.
Oh, sorry.
He himself and he doesn't come.
Sorry, no, ma.
So when I saw him in church, I started thanking God. I started thanking God. My praises moved from 50% to 100%. I praise God that Wednesday evening. God himself knew that Wednesday evening he was God. By the time we took the offering, no benediction. The person took the bag. No, just by the time we took offering. As if some military man was
sitting there. I'd say, oh, Jebby, and I saw
Senator.
Oh, no, Connor.
Come, Waira. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Any power that is using spiritual broom to sweep you from the house of God, that power is arrested in the name of Jesus Christ. You see, to me, be a whole any power to shield the back of your head that leave the house of God, that power is arrested in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare you planted in of God. I declare you established in the house of God. I declare you grounded in the house of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Say, I will last. In God. Say, I will last. In God. Verse 26.
He said,
when you serve the Lord, there shall nothing cast their young nor be barren in your land. The number of your days I will fulfill. So service to God terminates barrenness. Many people life is barren. Nothing is producing. God is giving us the key. So when you serve me, you attract my blessings. When you serve me, barrenness will be terminated. When you serve me, your life will not be unprofitable. When you serve me, you will not lose your fertility in life. When you serve me, I will enrich your life. When you serve me, I will decorate your life. When you serve me, I will dress your life. When you serve God, He will dress you. When you serve God, He will beautify you. When you serve God, your destiny will not be dry. When you serve God, your life will not be dull. When you serve God, every time you are full of life. When you serve God, you are lively. In the name of Jesus Christ, it is the service to God that ensures that the enemy cannot waste your destiny. If you serve God, you cannot be wasted. If you serve God, you will not suffer depletion, because you have invested in God. And God is the most safest place to invest your life and your resources. Barrenness shall be uprooted. The number of your days I will fulfill. So service to God brings new long life. The number of your days I will fulfill. Service to God will bring long life. So I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Every attempt to cut short your life, every attempt to terminate your life, is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Premature death is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Verse
27.
Service to God. Service to God. When you serve Him, your life will not become empty. Verse 27.
He
said, I'll send my fear before you. And I will destroy all the people that you shall come to. And I will make all your enemies to turn their back. When you serve me, I will send my fear before you. Yes. I will send my fear before you. Before you get there, the agents that are against you, I will strike them with fear. I will strike them with fear. The very agents that have been talking to you rough and by heart. When you serve God,
By the time you get to the office, God will send his fear ahead of you. By the time you get to the office, God will send his fear ahead of you. That's what he's saying. I will send my fear before you. God will terrorize them. God will frighten them. God will threaten them. You yourself, you don't know what to have. You don't know what to carry. But all of a sudden, there will be a shift and there will be a change. Because you are serving God and you are sent his fear. Any creature that has authority and power and influence, I want to use it to harass you. Today, I declare the Lord will frighten them. The Lord will terrorize them. The Lord will threaten them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. One day a certain man was driving in the night. And he got to a certain place. In the night he saw that they have mounted the roadblock and they were stopping the cars. Then he saw this man and a number of them holding guns and wearing dark glasses. And the man came to stand beside his window and said, "Dear gentleman, we are armed robbers. We are here to rob the people here. But when I saw you, something tells me that you are a good man. And so I should not touch you. So please, I beg you, give me something small. Dash me something small. I'm robber. God made the arm robber to see something extra about the man. Something that is hidden from human beings. An angel was there. He saw it. He said, "This one, don't touch. This one is serving me. With his life. He's serving me with time. This one. He's serving me with his expertise. He's serving me with his resources. You can touch others. But not this one. You can touch this. But you cannot touch this one. You can touch it, but you cannot touch this one. They are serving me. They are serving me with their heart, with their might, with their soul, with their mind. They are serving me. And this gentleman saw this armed robber smoking the weed, and the gentleman commoted money. Let me speak some pidgin English. He commoted the money.
Oh, yes, can.
He removed the money.
Oh, yes, can.
And dash it.
No man, be.
And left.
Oh, yeah, no, quay.
You will cross in the name of Jesus Christ.
I
said you will cross in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, I break the barrier. Say, break the limitation. Say, I break the blockade. In the name of Jesus Christ. You cannot serve God and the devil will be messing up with you. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And I left the police station with dignity. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You cannot serve God and the devil will be messing up
around
you. Must be something about you. Amen.
Amen.
When we come to church,
sorry,
and we are singing,
Yoma.
Some of us see the singing as a burden. We don't know that the singing is breaking things for us. Am I communicating to somebody? I will send my fear before you. Before you get there, God will take care of things. I said before you get there, God will take care of things. So if you are going somewhere and you are afraid, quote this scripture. Say, "Oh Lord, arise and send your fear before me."
Sorry.
If you are working in the office and everybody has turned against you in the office,
say,
"Oh Lord, arise, send your fear before me. Terrorize them. frighten them, threaten them, and you see what will happen. Shekinyasis will catch them. When you get there, something will happen. Say something is happening. Oh, say something is happening. He said, I will destroy all the enemies that will come against, that will confront. I will destroy all of them. There are some prayers you will not pray, but God will destroy them. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Then he said in verse 27, I will cause all your enemies to turn their back unto you. That means your enemies will reverse. Your enemies will retreat. Anything that is fighting you, God will contradict and resist that
thing.
God will dismantle them. And in verse 28, he said, I will send my hornets before you, which will drive out the Hivite, the Canaanite, the Hittite from before you. I will send my hornets. Hornets are a kind of insects. I'll send them before you. So any agent that is occupying your space, any agent that is occupying your seat, any agent that is occupying your position, God will send this insect ahead of you, and they will be removed, they will be dismissed, they will be uprooted, they will be cast out in the name of Jesus Christ. So when you serve God, there are benefits. I said, when you serve God, there are benefits. If somebody can open his mouth, a pastor can open his mouth, an elder can open his mouth, a prayer leader can open his mouth, that we have served God, we didn't see anything. That means you didn't serve him well. That means you served him with wrong motive.
Yes.
That means you served him without responsibility. Because if you serve him and you serve him well, something will come out of it. Something will come out of it. Some people serve God and they are not patient. Because the motive is wrong. They are not serving God out of love. They are not serving God out of love. So small time, no, they get angry, they get offended, and they vacate their post, they vacate their position. So there is nothing to show for it. Because the time was up when God was about to reward and elevate and honor. And they left their post. You shall not leave your post in the name of Jesus Christ. When you are serving God, Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9. How do you serve God? Or with what do you serve God? Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9. You said, honor or serve the Lord with your substance. And with the first fruits of your increase. Honor the Lord or serve the Lord with your substance. And with the first fruits of your increase. So God is not interested in leftovers. God is interested in substance. That you grow old and be 60 years before you say you are serving him. No. God says, serve me with something that is substantial. Yes, that's the meaning of the word substance. Something that is substantial.
No, person, say,
serve me with the things you value.
If you
value your wife or your husband, serve me with your wife and your husband.
Yes.
If you value your children, serve me with your children. Say, honor the Lord, serve the Lord with your substance. Something substantial, not leftovers. Honor the Lord with what is an asset to you. What you see as an asset, use it to serve God.
God
said, serve me with your resources. Not with what you don't value. Not with what you don't regard. He said, and with the first fruits of your increase. So God is saying, any increase you get, use the first part of the increase to serve me. The first fruits, the first results, the first breakthrough. Any increase you get, God is saying, the first part of it, give it to me. Use it to serve
me.
So God wants fresh, God wants new, and God wants the first. Because He is the Almighty. Seek first the kingdom and its righteousness. Then others will be added unto you. So God always demands and commands the first. If you want to be the first on His list, give Him the first.
So
the thing that is important to you, use it to serve God. That is how you serve God. Not what is worthless. Not what is useless. Not what is insignificant. That is not what you give to God. You give God what is heavy in your sight. That's what we mean by substance. You serve God with what you consider to be very significant. So many churchgoers, their life is looking like rags in Tomago.
I said Tomago.
The glory is not showing.
And daddy.
Look, there are times people will come and say, Borrow me 100 million. You know you don't have even 500 in your pocket. But they tell you that, borrow me 100 million. Yes. It means there is something they are seeing about you that you are not seeing. It means there is a glory of wealth and riches on you. They have seen it. So even though you are wearing dresses that are torn and that has worn out and that have faded, there is a glory of God. The riches of God has surrounded you. And they have seen it. So you are a man and a woman of substance. So when they come to you,
look down on yourself.
May the Lord open your eyes to see what He has put upon your life. I said, may the Lord open your eyes to see what He has put upon your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So anytime they are requesting something higher from you, their eyes have been opened to see it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Their eyes have been opened to see it. And truly, truly too, that glory is upon your life. That beauty is upon your life. That riches is upon your life. That honor is upon your life. I command manifestation in the name of Jesus Christ. I command manifestation in the name of Jesus Christ. David was in the forest and was a shepherd, but God said he is a king.
Now David was as a kese no sunsun nyame se no your hene.
Am I talking to somebody at all? Joseph was in prison, but God said he's what? He's a prime minister.
Now Joseph owe fiase sunsun nyame agi.
God knows how to navigate. God, he knows how to what? Navigate. To use circumstances and crisis to elevate you. To use mistakes and errors and accidents to elevate you, to facilitate you, to promote you, and to honor you. Just serve God. Say, I'll serve the Lord. Oh, say it well. Say, I'll serve the Lord. As I close, I want you to know that service to God is not a position. It is a choice. Service to God. It is not a position. It is a choice. Joshua 24 verse 15. And if you think it is evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom you will serve. Whether the gods of your fathers that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are dwelling, but as for me and my house, you shall serve the Lord. He said, choose you this day whom you shall serve. But as for me and my house, I don't need conversation with you. As for me and my house, I don't need your opinion. I don't need your comment on that matter. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. If you have decided that you will not serve God, as for me and my house, you may be my cousin, you may be my brother, you may be my sister. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. He said, choose you this day whom we shall serve. So service to God is a choice. It's a position. It's not a position. No, it's not a title. It is not a calling. It's not a calling. It is a choice. It is a choice. Amen. May the Lord enable you to make that choice in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, may the Lord enable you to make that choice in the name of Jesus Christ. It is a choice. It is a decision. It is a voluntary decision. I have decided to serve the Lord. Stimulate me to serve you in the name of Jesus Christ. Say by the Spirit of God. Say by the Spirit of God. Spiritual dullness in my life. Break and expire. Say by the Spirit of the Lord. Spiritual dullness in my life. Break and expire. In the name of Jesus Christ. Sit down. Sit down. What are you talking about? Amen. Anytime somebody comes to church, he has overcome a lot of demons. Anytime somebody comes to church, he has overcome a lot of demons.
Yes.
Anytime somebody comes to church, he has overpowered a lot of demons. Because if you operate in the spirit, you know that one of the preoccupation of demons is to prevent people from going to church.
Because
there is something about the prayers and the praises and the word of God that will lose the people, that will break chains and liberate them. The devil doesn't want it. So anytime they come, maybe five of the chains are broken. Five is broken. If I allow him to go the next Sunday, another five will break. Another ten will break. Whatever excuse I will give him, legitimate and illegitimate, I will give him. The next Sunday, he will not go.
Sorry.
Praise God. Yes. So next Sunday he will not go, then they will go and add another 10 chains. So every time their life is back and forth.
Back.
But if you go consistently, the deliverance shall be completed. The healing shall be completed. The miracle shall be completed. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every unfinished business in your life that the Lord has started, I pray that it shall be completed. I pray that it shall be completed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For the word of the Lord said, he who has started a good work in your life, the enemy cannot interfere. The enemy cannot interrupt. He who has started a good work in your life, he will finish it. He will complete it. He will finish it. In the name of Jesus, say, I declare satanic interference. Say, satanic interference. Break. Say, satanic interference. Break. Say, satanic interruptions. Break. In the name of Jesus, say, what the Lord has started shall be completed. Say, I declare there shall be no negotiation about my life. Say, I declare there shall be no negotiation about my destiny. Say, I declare there shall be no negotiation about my expectation. In the name of Jesus, I can see what the Lord has prepared for you. I can see what the Lord has organized for you. I can see what the Lord has arranged for you. And I declare the adversary shall scatter. The adversary shall scatter. In the name of Jesus, for a great door has been opened to me. But there are many adversaries. I declare in the name of Jesus, let every adversary scatter. Let every adversary scatter. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy of your life that as the Lord is taking you to level 6, as the Lord is taking you to level 6, as the Lord is taking you to level 10, no power will keep you at level 1. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for you. You will not be satisfied with your level. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of complacency that is working against your life is broken. In the name of Jesus, I command your eyes to open to see where the Lord is taking you. In the name of Jesus, I command your ears to open to hear what the Lord is saying unto you. In the name of Jesus, I declare right now you will see the end of the journey. I said you will see the end of the journey. You will cross the river. You will not be left in the middle. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Say, Holy Ghost, as you are selecting. Say, Holy Ghost, as you are selecting, select me also.
There were many fishermen there. He went to select only 12 out of them. He went.
Yes.
When he got to the sea, there were many fishermen there. When he got to the sea, he saw that the star of God has come upon Peter. God said, yes, select him. He saw that the star of God has come upon James. He said, this is the one, select him. He saw that the star of God has come upon John. He said, pick this one. And he selected 12 out of the many. May the star of God come upon your life. May the star of God come upon your life.